Hi everyone. In the last couple of videos, we learned about delegation pattern and how Kotlin supports it natively using by keyword. The point is, creating and using delegates in Kotlin is super easy. And in this video, we will do something much more easier. For common use cases that are often required, Kotlin Standard Library has some predefined delegates. And if a delegate is already there for you, you do not need to create it. So in this video, we will learn about some delegates available in Kotlin Standard Library. And we will start with lazy. Assume you have a class and creating the instance of this class is very expensive. By expensive, I mean it is a heavy class that may require some time to instantiate, and hence it may cause a delay in your code. For the sake of example, I have this class student heavy here. It's not actually a heavy class, but we will just consider that it is a heavy class. Now we have one more class that requires an instance of heavy class. So if we create an instance of the second class, that is student, it will also instantiate the student heavy instance that we have inside this student class. But is it necessary? We may have scenarios where we do not need this heavy class instance. So instantiating this heavy class for the cases where it is not needed is useless. And to solve this problem, we have the concept of lazy loading. It means we should instantiate the instance only when it is needed. And we can achieve this thing using lazy delegate. That is the part of Kotlin Standard Library. Now let's see how it works. Now if I run this code, you can see this init block is getting called. That means whenever we initialize an instance of the student instance, this class also get initialized, but we do not want. We want this instance to load lazy. That means we will initialize this heavy only when it is needed. So what we can do is we can use the lazy delegate. So instead of instantiating the class directly, we will use by, and we will use the delegate that is lazy. And inside the trailing lambda, we will instantiate the class. So here we can write student heavy. Now if I run the code, I will see this class is not instantiated because the init block is not called in this case, because this time we are loading or we are instantiating the heavy by lazy. And this means this class will be instantiated only when it is accessed. And in this case, we are not accessing the heavy instance. But what if I will write student.heavy like this? Now in this case, this class will be instantiated. That is student heavy. You can see we are getting the student heavy initialized, and it means this time this heavy instance is getting instantiated because we are accessing it now. But after instantiating this class one time, it will use the same thing. That means it will not initialize the instance again and again and again. It will instantiate only once. So even if I'm accessing the instance three times, it will call the constructor only once, as you can see here. So this is what we can do with lazy delegate. Whenever we want to lazy load an instance, we can use the lazy delegate. Now we have one more delegate that is called observable. So whenever you want to observe the changes, you can use observable delegate. So let's see how you can use observable. So I will keep the lazy here for your reference. And this time we will remove this thing. And what I will do is I will create one more val inside this student class, and this time I will write, let's say, val marks of type int by delegates dot observable. Now to the constructor we pass the initial value. So let's say the initial marks is 50, and then we will pass a trailing lambda like this. Now this trailing lambda requires some parameters, as you can see here. So this is basically the onChange function, and here we pass property, old value and new value. So here we can type property, and from the drop down we can select the parameters required. So we have property that contains the meta information, then we have old value and we have the new value. Now whenever you will change this marks, you will get the old value and the new value that is assigned. So just for the sake of example, I will write here println old value and old value, and I will also write new value. Now if I will access this marks, let's say student dot marks equals to 70, and this marks is val, so if I want to change it, I need to make it a var like this. So we have student dot marks equals to 70, then let's change it again, let's say 80, and if I run the code now, you can see old value was 50, then we changed it to 70, then now the old value is 70 and we changed it to 80. So whenever you want to observe the changes in a variable, you can use this observable delegate. Now there is one more delegate. Let's say we have var age of type int, and we have by delegates dot vetoable. Now with the help of this delegate, you can intercept the assignment. So you can pass a condition, and that condition must be true to assign the new value to this variable. So again, we will pass the initial value. Let's say we have 14. And again, we will pass a trailing lambda, and it requires some parameters. So we can write property and select the values from the dropdown. So we have property, old value and new value. Now here we need to write a condition that must be true to assign the new value. So here we can write, let's say new value must be greater than or equals to 40. Now we can change the age only when the given value is greater than or equals to 14. So let's say we want to assign 13. So we have student dot age equals to 13. And to see the results, we will also print new value and old value. So I will write println new age. It is new value, and we will write old age, let's say old value like this, and at the last we have the condition that should be true to successfully assign the new value. Now let's try assigning some values. First I tried 13, then 12, and at last I will try 15. Now let's run the code to see what happens. I will comment this thing because I don't want to see this output in the console. So let's run the code. Now here you can see, first we tried to assign 13 to the age variable, and that is why here the new age is 13 and the old age is 14. Then we tried to assign 12 to the age variable, and here you can see the new age that we passed is 12. And the old age is still 14. This means this assignment was not successful because the condition that we have given here, that new value must be greater than or equals to 14, is false. And that is why the old age is 14 only. But when the third time we tried to assign 15, it is assigned, and we are not seeing it here because we have not printed. So let's try to print the age value. So I will write println student.age like this, and I will write it after every assignment. Now let's see by running the code again. So you can see the value is 14, the value is 14. And when we passed a value that satisfies the condition, the value is changed. So if you want to intercept the assignment, you can use this vetoable delegate. So that's all for the predefined delegates in Kotlin. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. In case you have any problem or question, you can leave your comments, and you can get all the codes in the link that is given in the description of this video. Now please subscribe if you are not already a subscriber, and please share this video with all your friends if you think this video is helpful. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan, now signing off.